India promised a lot following the 2012 gang rape of a physiotherapy student so brutal that she died of her injuries. It would give legal aid to victims, make it easier for rape survivors to register the crime, develop a more sensitive police force and fast-track courts to expedite cases. It would add more streetlights and CCTV cameras to make women feel safer. Let's put all that to one side because hardly any of it has happened. What about the hope that Indian women would be less at risk of sexual violence and harassment because of the jolt to the national conscience from a case that shook the country to its core? Let's park that on one side too, because women are just as vulnerable as before. Their daily lives are still ruled by fear. And if they are unfortunate enough to be raped, a report last month by Human Rights Watch showed that they will still be subjected to humiliation and doubt and questioned about their promiscuity and moral character by police and health workers. Let's ask instead about the fundamental point: has the average Indian man changed at all in his attitude towards women? Get the latest news and updates emailed straight to your inbox. By submitting your email, you are agreeing to Fairfax Media's terms and conditions and privacy policy. Judging by the latest rape statistics released by the National Crime Records Bureau on November the 30th, it appears not. Rape cases rose by 12.4% in 2016 after a dip between 2014 and 2015. The increase is probably the result of more women being prepared to report the crime, but it certainly shows that if women hoped the 2012 gang rape would usher in a more progressive male mentality, they were wrong. Regressive attitudes towards women are rooted in India's deeply traditional and conservative culture, in which women embody a family and community's izzat, or honor. The clothes they wear, where they go, at what time, with whom, must be controlled lest they bring dishonor and disgrace through unacceptable behavior, such as being seen with a man who is not a relative, smoking, drinking, dancing, wearing revealing clothes or being out after dark. Men who believe women should not be free to live as they wish are not monsters. Many are hard-working, decent men trying to do the best for their families in very trying circumstances. But the basic fact is that, barring a westernized elite that is so minuscule it barely counts, they cannot countenance giving women the personal and social freedoms that are taken for granted in the West. Take Vidra Kumar, 37, who sells flowers on the roadside in South Delhi. Married with young children, he says emphatically that the men who raped and killed Jayati Singh Pandey with unbelievable ferocity after she boarded a bus with a male friend to go home after seeing the film Life of Pi on December 16, 2012, should hang for their savagery. Though the Indian government flew Pandey to Singapore for an intestinal transplant, her assailants used an iron rod that ripped out her intestines. She died on December the 29th. Kumar expresses sympathy with Pandey and her family but insists that women need to watch what they do.